In this lecture, we'll be taking a look at routing in ASP.NET MVC. So over here in our code, startup.cs, you can see that we have defined a route, and this route contains three things: controller, action, and then an optional parameter ID. Now, this is a very generic syntax for defining a route. Every route that we define contains a controller, then an action method, and then some optional parameters. Over here, we have three ways of accessing this particular route that we are calling default route. For instance, over here, you can see that the default route, that is without any controller name, without any action name, and without the optional parameter, it is serving me this content ASP.NET Core MVC course. And this is coming from the home controller's index method. The reason why it is able to do so is because over here, we have defined that if you do not find any controller name, make use of the home controller. If you do not find any action name, make use of the index action. And obviously, the parameter is optional. So here, it matches that route and prints this text. The other way of accessing the same route is by mentioning home. And then you can see that we have skipped the name of the action method. And here, by default, it is taking index as the action method. Similarly, I can further go ahead and specify the action as well. Now you can see the ID parameter, which is optional, has been removed over here. And if I go ahead and provide that as well, obviously we are not making use of this in our index route. You can see over here, no parameters, but in our courses, we are making use of the ID, and there we were showing it. So this is how we can define a pattern for our route, and based on that, it will find the matching controller action and optional parameters. It will do the model binding as we explained in the previous lecture and serve the content. There's one more thing about this optional parameter, and that is we can restrict this to specific data types. For instance, if I want to restrict this ID to be of type integer only, then I can just type here as ID colon int, and then obviously the question mark remains because this parameter will be optional. So using this approach, we can create different routes in our application and make use of them.